Yes, my name is Jeremiah Christopher from Educare Tanzania. I'm here in front of you today to proceed with our topic, which is the materials of the earth or structures of the earth. As we discussed the last sessions, we see there is different materials that is composed within the earth surface. We see there is element, there is mineral, also there is rock. So in rocks, we said that rock refer to the aggregate of mineral in solid state. So in the rock also, we see there is different types of rock. There is igneous rock, sedimentary rock, and metamorphic rock. Also we see the mode of formations of rocks. We also see the place of occurrence, as well as the different process concerned about the rock. So we discussed the igneous rock, how it's formed. Also discussed igneous rock according to the place of occurrence. Also today now we are going to see the sedimentary rock. As we said that sedimentary rock can be formed organically, also can be formed mechanically, as well as it can be formed chemically. So let's just see mechanically formed sedimentary rock. These are rock which have been formed by the compaction and sedimentation of the sediment. What is those different particles of rock that is sediment? When compacted together, they tend to form the sedimentary rock, which have laid down on sandy. Those sediment tend to lie down on sandy or on the sea floor. They are formed through accumulations. So this kind of sediment that is laid down on the sand, they tend to be formed through the accumulation or the deposition process. Also, lithification of weathered materials, for example, igneous rock, is then to form those sediments through weathering. Also, sediments tend to be formed through the deposition, lithification, also sedimentary rock. So that is how mechanically formed sedimentary rock. So let's just now proceed. Particularly, rock is disintegrated and weathered material formed are deposited in layers to form sedimentary rock. This rock can be classified into the following. So let us now see mechanically sedimentary rock formed. So those kind of rocks or sedimentary rock that is formed mechanically is, the first one is arena shells. Arena shells, these are formed through deposition of particles with medium size of sand. Those particles that have medium size, for example, sandstones, are the samples of arena shells sedimentary rock. Another one is glaciers rock. These are formed from deposition and lithification of weathered material of very fine or small particles. This is formed through those weathered materials that having the fine and small particles. So those fine and small particles tend to form the glaciers sedimentary rock, and it is through deposition and lithification process. So let's just now see chemically formed sedimentary rock. As we see, sedimentary rock formed into the different ways. There is a organically formed sedimentary rock, also there is a mechanically formed sedimentary rock, and another one is chemically formed sedimentary rock. These are rock formed through chemical process or decomposition. Here there are chemical processes that contributed much to the formation of this kind of rock. The basic chemical process include carbonation. This is kind of the chemical that plays a great role in the formation of the sedimentary rock, which is the reaction between weak carbonic acid with rock containing calcium carbonate. So the reactions that occur between weak carbonic acid with rock containing calcium carbonate. Those are the chemicals. After those chemicals reaction, it leads to the formation of the sedimentary rock. So calcium carbonate plus water plus carbon dioxide plus calcium bicarbonate is where we get the sedimentary rock that is formed chemically. So through the combination of these elements tend to formation of the sedimentary rock chemical. So calcium carbonate plus water plus carbon dioxide plus calcium bicarbonate tend to form sedimentary rock chemical. So those reactions of chemical contributed much to the formations of the sedimentary rock. Other processes include those of sulfates, chloride, silicate, and iron, stone, etc. Also through the combinations of these chemicals also lead to the formations of sedimentary rock chemicals. So here is a graph that shows how the rock is formed mechanically, organically, and chemically. So as we see that mechanically, rocks, shells, mudstone, silt is created as samples of the rock that is formed mechanically. Organically, there are chalk, limestone, coal, and coral reefs. Those are formed organically. While chemically, there are gypsum, flint, iron, stones, and etc. Those are shown chemically, mechanically, and organically. So let us now see what are the characteristics of sedimentary rock. The first characteristics of sedimentary rock is they are non-crystalline. These are not hard. If something says crystalline, means that is not hard. So that is among the characteristics of the sedimentary rock. Another characteristic of sedimentary rock is they contain fossils as a relative accumulation of skeletons and shells of once living organisms. As we know that these fossils tend to be formed through the accumulations of skeletons of remains, organisms, and shells. So through the accumulation of skeletons and shells of different organisms tend to the formation of the fossil. So sedimentary rock is characterized by it containing fossil. Another characteristic of sedimentary rock is they can undergo changes to form metamorphic rock when they are influenced by pressure and temperature. So this kind of rock, when it's influenced by pressure and temperature, tends to undergo the changes in order to form the metamorphic rock. So if the sedimentary rock is placed in the place where there is pressure and temperature, those pressures and temperature tend to influence sedimentary rock to form the metamorphic rock. Another, they are consisted of some fragments which were deposited and then cemented to form a rock. So also in sedimentary rock there is a small particles that is called fragment, which tend to be deposited together and sedimented together to form the rock. Since you have seen that rocks are those combination of small particles of minerals that are forming the rock. So through those some fragments which were deposited and then cemented to form the rock. So that are the characteristics of the sedimentary rock. So after finishing to see how the sedimentary rock is formed through the different ways, now let us see another type C of rock, which is metamorphic rock. Metamorphic rock, these are rock which are formed when one type of rock changes into another type of rock after being subjected under intense heat or pressure or both. This is kind of rock that is formed through one type of rock is tend to be intensely by heat or pressure. So through those types of rock after being intensely by heat or pressure or both, it leads to the formation of metamorphic rock. Or in other way, you can say it's referred to the kind of rock that is formed through metamorphism process. Also, that is the definitions of metamorphic rock. So our definition here tells us these are rock which are formed when one type of rock, either sedimentary rock or igneous rock, change into another type of rock. After changing into another type of rock, after being subjected under the intensive heat or pressure or both, it leads to the formation of metamorphic rock. So any rock can change to form metamorphic rock. So the point to note here, student, is that any kind of rock, either sedimentary rock or igneous rock, tend to change to form the metamorphic rock. For example, there is a diagram here which show the picture of metamorphic rock. So there are the different processes that show on how those different types of rock change to form metamorphic rock. For example, as we said that metamorphic rock is a kind of rock in which any kind of rock, either igneous rock or sedimentary rock, tend to change when it's subjected to the heat or pressure or both to form the metamorphic rock. As we know that the metamorphic rock is formed when the any types of rock change into another types of rock. So let us now see sedimentary rock to metamorphic rock. Here are the sample of the sedimentary rock, which is shown on how they change to form the metamorphic rock. The first one is sandstorm to quartzite. That is the sandstones are found in the sedimentary rock. So when they tend to change which is caused by either intensivity or pressure, it is the formation of this kind of metamorphic rock. So limestones can able to change into marble. So here we see now sedimentary rock change to metamorphic rock, also coal change into graphite, clay changes to slate, mudstone into slate. Those are the samples of changes that show on how sedimentary rock tend to change into metamorphic rock. So metamorphic rock to metamorphic rock, for example, slate can able to change to sheet. So even metamorphic rock can tend to change from metamorphic rock into metamorphic rock. Also, here there is igneous rock to metamorphic rock. So as we said earlier, that metamorphic rock is that kind of rock in which can change into another types of rock. So okay, for example, igneous rock to metamorphic rock, here there is augite to hornblende. So also there is a granite to gneiss. So this is a kind of igneous rock that tend to change into the metamorphic rock. So the process which involves the change of one rock type to another type of rock is called metamorphism. So the point to note here is that the metamorphic rocks, it can be able to be formed through the metamorphism process, since metamorphic rock is formed when the one types of rock change into another types of rock. So through the process of metamorphism, we can able to form the metamorphic rock. So the point to note here, student, is that the process which involves the changes of one rock type to another types of rock, that kind of process is called metamorphism. So let us now see what are the different types of metamorphism. Now there are three kind of metamorphism. The first one is dynamic metamorphism. It's influenced by the pressure because of the excess movement and they bring about the mountain formation. So this is kind of the metamorphism process where it is influenced due to the presence of the pressure, because that kind of pressures cause earth movement and they bring about the formation of the mountain. So through the occurrence of this kind of metamorphism process, there are different features that will be formed due to the result of the earth movement, like those which include the mountains formation. So example is shale to schist, clay to slate, and granite to gneiss. So that is a kind of metamorphism process. Another is thermal or contact metamorphism. This is caused by intensive heat. So now we see the difference between thermal and dynamic metamorphism. Thermal, this is caused by the intensive heat, while dynamic, those tend to be influenced by the pressure. So there is a difference between thermal and dynamic metamorphism. This is caused by intense heat. This kind of metamorphism occurs due to the presence of intensive heat. This can take place when the rock comes into contact with hot molten material like magma or lava. For example, limestone to marble, sandy stone to quartzite, and etc. So another is the thermodynamic. Here we see the combination. So this kind of metamorphism process is tend to be influenced by both heat and pressure. So this is a process that takes place as a result of combination of heat and pressure. Since we see, when we say thermal, we mean that temperature. Thermal means what? Temperature. So this is the kind of metamorphism process that is influenced by the heat, while dynamic, this kind of metamorphism process that is influenced by the pressure. So, but thermodynamic metamorphism is another type of metamorphism process in which occurred due to the influence of both heat and pressure. So through the influence of both heat and pressure, we can get the thermodynamic metamorphism. So it is when the existing rock are subjected to both pressure and heat. So after rock to be subjected by both heat and pressure is where we get the different types of rocks. For example, coal can coal, if coal tend to be intensive by both heat and pressure, we can get the graphite. So the process of coal to change into graphite, that process is called the thermodynamic metamorphism, because both heat and pressure tend to be applied here in order the coal to change into graphite. So let us now see, after finishing those processes of metamorphism, so we see there is a dynamic metamorphism, there is thermodynamic metamorphism, and there is same metamorphism. So let's just now jump to see what are those characteristics of metamorphic rock. They are more hardy and more resistant than the original rock. So one among the characteristics of metamorphic rock is they are more hardy and resistant. So this kind of rock, it is more hardy and resistant. So that is among the characteristics of the metamorphic rock. Another is they are formed when any types of rock, even the other metamorphic rock, change into the types of rock. This is formed when the one types of rock tend to change into another types of rock. So metamorphic rock characterized by it is occur when any types of rock change into another types of rock to form it. So it can undergo also weathering to form sedimentary rock after melting and cooling into can form the igneous rock. So when metamorphic rocks undergo weathering, weathering is referred to those disintegration of the rock that is exposed to the earth surface. So after metamorphic rock to undergo the weathering process, it tend to form to the sedimentary rock, since there is a small particles of rock that is called the sediment. So those sediment after melting and cooling lead to the formation of the igneous rock. That is another characteristic of metamorphic rock. So another is most of them are foliated, they are composed of thin layer. So that is another characteristic of metamorphic rock, that is characterized by those kinds of rocks that is found in this kind of metamorphic rock, characterized by thin and foliated layers. That are the characteristics that explain the metamorphic rock. So after finishing there, let us now see rocky cycle. Rock cycle is a relationship into which rock tend to change from one type into another types. Here we're going to see the cycles of rocks formation. The rock tend to be formed and tend to move from one type of rock into another types of rock. As we see that those sedimentary rocks can undergo weathering and forming the small particles that is called the sediment. So after melting and the cooling of those sediment led to the formation of igneous rock. So now we see the relationship in which one type of rock change into another type of rock. For example, the rock can change from igneous rock to sedimentary rock, also metamorphic, and go back into the igneous rock. So as we see example here, the igneous rock can able to undergo metamorphism process to form the metamorphic rock. So even sedimentary rock can undergo melting due to the process of some heats and pressure and forming the magma. So that is the rocky cycle. So in the rock cycle, any types of rock can form another types of rock through different processes. So the point is to note that in the rock cycle, any types of rock can able to form any types of rock through the different processes that will be applied in order to form that kind of rock. So here is a rocky cycle. We see here now, this is magma, those molten materials that is from the mantle or core. After reaching the surface, they tend to cool and solidify and form lava. So this is magma and this is metamorphic rock here. We see now metamorphic rocks can able to undergo the melting process and forming the magma. So magma can able to undergo cooling process and form in the igneous rock. As well as igneous rock, it can able to undergo heat and pressure to form metamorphic rock. So as well as we see now here, sedimentary rock can be influenced by intensive heat and pressure to form the metamorphic rock. Also, metamorphic rocks now, it can able to undergo the weathering process. As we know that weathering is where the rock tend to be disintegrated into small pieces. So after those pieces of rock to be disintegrated, lead to the lithification. When we say lithification, we mean that those small types, those small sediment tend to be lithified together to form the sediment. So that is kind of the rocky cycle. As we see now here, this after molten material to cool and solidifies, it can undergo weatherings and lithification process to form those small pieces, which is sediment. As well as those sediments, it can be compacted and cemented together to form the sedimentary rock. So now we see the rocky cycle. One types of rocky tend to change into another types of rocky through the different processes. So that is kind of rocky cycle. So there are the different processes that involved in the rocky cycle. But so after finishing to see the rock cycle, let us now see the different processes that involved in the rocky cycle. First, at the first, igneous rock may be formed due to the cooling and the solidification of magma or lava. So after those molten materials that occur after eruption take place, those materials, when they reach the surface, they tend to cool and to solidify. After cool and solidify, lead to the formations of the igneous rock. That is the first process in the process of the rocky cycle. Another is, then igneous rock can be attacked by weathering agent to form sediments, which can be deposited and compacted or cemented together to form a sedimentary rock. So after igneous rock to be formed, the second process is that those agents of erosions like winds, colds, ice, and etc. tend to disintegrate this kind of rocks to form the smallest particles of rock, which is called sediment. So after forming those sediment, they tend to be deposited and compacted or cemented together to form sedimentary rock. That is the second process. The second one is, then the igneous rock or sedimentary rock can undergo metamorphism due to the influence of pressure and heat to form metamorphic rock. So either igneous rock or sedimentary rock, it can undergo the metamorphism process to form the pressure and metamorphism rock due to the influence of both pressure and heat. So the fifth process is likewise, metamorphic rock can undergo the further metamorphism to form either another or more metamorphic rock like silts, which is changed to form the slate. So as we see that the metamorphic rock can change from metamorphic rock into metamorphic rock through the process of the metamorphism. So the examples are slate will able to change to form the slate. So that is another processes of rock cycle. The fifth one is only rock that is either sedimentary or metamorphic, which is subjected to heat and a high temperature, can melt and cool to form an igneous rock. So either it can be either sedimentary rock or metamorphic rocks, it will be subjected by heat or temperature. After being subjected by heat and temperature, they tend to melt and hence tend to cool as well as tend to form the igneous rock. So either sedimentary rock or metamorphic rocks can tend to melt due to the intense heat and pressure. And after being melted, it tends to cool and hence form the igneous rock. That is a processes that is influenced in the formations of rock. Now let us see the classification of rocky according to age. Also, you can able to classify the rocky according to age. Rock can be classified according to age. The age of each rock can be indicated on the geological time scale. Geological time scale refers to the chart that show the different events and epochs of rock. So this geological time scale represents the ages of different rock. Either it can be metamorphic rock, sedimentary rock, or igneous rock. All those kinds of rock are shown their age through the process of the geological time scale. So geological time scale is a chart used for dating the history of the earth, including rock. So this chart attempts to describe different periods. These charts show the periods and eras which can be formed. So not only age, also it shows the eras and the periods of the different rocks and the times of their formation. So geological time scale divides geological time extending to about 600 million years. So according to the age, rock can be classified in two. So now we're going to see the classification of rocks according to the age. As we said, that the age of the rock can be classified due to the presence of this kind of chart, which is geological time scale chart. So according to the age, rock can be classified into, the first one is the Precambrian era, Paleozoic era, Mesozoic era, as well as the Cenozoic era. Precambrian era is the first. The second one is the Paleozoic era, or in other words, you can call it ancient life. Those periods of ancient life is what we call it Paleozoic era. Also, Mesozoic era is a middle life. So, and the other is Cenozoic era, which is recent life. We are dealing now with the present. So, the last three eras are described as the primary and the secondary and the tertiary eras respectively. The Cretaceous era represents rock aged 1 up to 2 million years ago. Each era is divided into periodic system, which in turn may be divided into series of formations. So this geological time scale shows a series of rock with their ages and their different epochs. So let us now see the geological time scale. Here there is a division of era. There is a division of period, years in million, and a major geological event in Africa. So here are those major geological events in Africa. As we said, geological, here we are going to deal with the rock. That's why we call it geological time scale. It shows the age of rock, those periods. So now, era, there is a Cenozoic era, which says that is a recent era. Also, there is a Mesozoic era, which says that is a middle life. Also, there is another one is Paleozoic era, and another one is Precambrian era. This shows the columns of era. There is a Precambrian era, there is a Cenozoic era, also there is a Cenozoic era. So after finishing to see those eras of the rock, now we are going to see the period. Now in the period, there is Neocenes, also there is Oligocenes, also there is Eocenes. So also there is Cretaceous, also there is Jurassic, also there is Triassic and Permian, also there is Carboniferous, also there is Devonian, Silurian and Cambrian. So also there is upper, middle, lower Azoic. So this is a columns of the period. Those are the periods that is shown in the geological time scale and show the different rocks that occur into different times. So now we are going to see years in millions. So these kinds of periods, those rock lives here at the first, there is 70 million years, there is 135 years, also there is 180 million years, also there is 225, also there is 230, also there are 108, also there are 345, as well as there is 405, also there is 425, also there are 500s and 600s. These are the years of the rock that is displayed to show the different years in millions. So those are the years in million, which indicate the different years of the era. So now let us see those major geological events. Here we are going to see those geological events in Africa. So the first is main period of volcanic activities. EA began main period 14 years where there is occurrence of the faulting in East Africa. So also there is Alpine S movement formed the Atlas Mountain is that times where is it be formed. So there is a deposition of materials, sediment in Sahara and South Nigeria. So those are the different events that is formed during that day. Also there is a break of Pangaea. As we know that, yeah, during those days, all continents was one large landmass that is called the Pangaea. So that is among the events that is shown. So also there is a Drakensberg lava formation. So during those times, there is a Drakensberg lava formation of Upper Karoo and the volcanic activity. So there is a difference geological events that are taking place those days. Also there are formation of lower Karoo beds, formation of coal. So during those days, all the formations of coal and etc. For example, in TZ, Zimbabwe and South Africa, there are formations of coal. So there is a formation of Cape Field. Also during this is among the geological periods that take place during the Paleozoic era. So also the marine invasions in Libya. Libya tend to invade the marines. Also Sahara and the West Sudan. Continental bases formed by warping. So also there is a deposition of sediment. During those days there is a kind of another geological feature which is the depositions of sediment. So also in the year of 5 million years ago, marine invasions of West Sahara and Kalahari Basin. So another geological actions that is all forms that take place during those days, there is ancient mountain building and ancient glaciation in South Equator. So also there is oldest recorded rock of 3,500 million years ago from South Africa. So those are the geological features that occurring during those days in Africa. So after finishing to see those differences, different eras and years of how rocks have been formed. So let's just now leave you the question to do, which the questions need you to explain the processes of rock cycle. Here we're going to see the different processes that involved in the formations of the rock. So do it individually and we will continue with the next session. So thank you for your cooperation and we'll see you later.